This video is an overview of Access Control Lists, or ACLs. ACLs are security rules that control users' access to data in system tables. ACLs control access to entire tables and to individual fields within a table. ACLs allow or deny access based on any or all of three things: the role of the user who's requesting access, conditions in effect at the time, like the state of an incident, and a script that's part of the ACL. Let's take a look at an ACL. For this example, we'll look at an ACL defined for the incident table. We'll access it through one of the open incidents. To work with ACLs, we need to be logged in as system administrator, and we'll need to elevate our role to security admin. Now that we've elevated our role, the Configure menu contains an extra item, Security Rules. That takes us to a list of all the ACLs that apply to the incident table. Notice that this list includes ACLs that apply to all tables, ACLs that apply to just the incident table, and ACLs that apply to the task table, which is the parent of the incident table. As we mentioned, ACLs grant or deny access based on user roles, conditions, or ACL scripts. Here's one that's based on a role. This ACL lets the user see all fields in the incident table if the user has the ITIL role. Here's an ACL that's based on conditions. This one lets the user write to the caller field in the incident table if the user is the caller or the one who opened the incident. And finally, here's an ACL that's based on a script. This one lets the user create any field in any table if the user has write access to that field in the Security Manager. This concludes our video. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.